I hit it. I got her out. So some of you, and again, in Yoshinkan Aikido, we really believe by controlling our posture, we can control the opponent. So we talk about Chushin, right? And the idea here is from the posture, we can control the opponent. So you'll notice Yoshinkan is always straight back. And the idea is if you lean back, it's weak. If you lean forward, it's weak. You have to get it straight. So who's heard the sentence that from the founder of Aikido, Yoshinkan Sensei, that Budo is like walking? Has anyone ever heard that?
Yes.
Right? So you don't walk this way, you don't walk this way. Once or twice, I've been known to walk this way. But when you walk normally. Stay soft, knuckle. Shoulder width, there's your command. Okay? And everything is straight. Shoulders are down. It's a Japanese expression, it's called wakiyoshimeru. That means close your side. So you're lax, actually pull your shoulders down and back. You know, you do that, didn't you?
Yes.
Alright? Then if you want, you can do funky stuff with med. And just by stretch straight, and we say wakiyoshimeru, then you can move. You don't have to use any cross. So once you get that strong center line in your body, it's very powerful. Alright? And where's the movie? Look here, movie. Always looking. Oh, no. Alright, it's very interesting. From here, you come on. It's very interesting. Now, when he looks down, he breaks his line. Two fingers. He's strong. Move down. Still two fingers. That's not very powerful. If you ever get attacked by someone with only two fingers, you're in big trouble. If you're in Kamae, it's straight and strong, so from here, now, it's very strong. And the moment, this. It's a little known secret in martial arts that if you don't breathe, you die. Right? You have to breathe. How's that feel? You sing Lady Gaga songs? Right, so make sure you don't look down. If you do look down, I have what's called the Aikido Yoshinkai Burn V Don't Look Down Fixer thingy. You want to see it? Okay, come on. Yeah, it works. Right. So then, basically, from the Kamae, the Kihon Dosa, the basic movements, teach us how to keep that Kamae feeling as we move. So eventually, you start to understand, in Yoshinkan Aikido, we have six basic movements, but we always only have one. Because when you're in this strong position, Taino Henko Ichi, Taino Henko Ni, Hiriki no Yosei Ichi, Hiriki no Yosei ni, Shumatsu dosa ichi, Shumatsu dosa ni, Irumina, Wangan, Iruminage, Zanshi, Nijate Kokunage, Kenshinage, it's all there. And a good thing, when you go wide and low, especially for you young guys, go wide and low, please. When you go wide and low, you get strong, and you don't have a tofu butt. But this is a tofu butt. Alright, what you want is, how's that feel? Solid, right? The chicks need it. I'm telling you, dude. You check any bar, you watch the bar. I'll bet Lucy did it to you in the bar. You're kind of walking and say, hey, how you doing? Right? You have to get it, so there.
This is it.
And the idea is it makes your legs strong and it helps you start to relax. Once you get to this strong position here, you can start to relax. And then it's the same feeling. If Chris leans on me and pushes, go ahead. Then you're ready. From the knee. So whether inside those six basic movements, we have three principles: moving forward, pivoting, and shifting. And most people, if you go watch on YouTube, you can see people pivoting around. And that's kind of integral to Aikido. And we'll start some pivoting so you can get used to it. See if H remembers, what's the most important thing when you pivot? She forgot. Everyone say, that's right.
Yes.
Do not lose your front foot when you pivot. If you move your front foot when you pivot, what happens? You get killed. Or when I say with my kids, if you move your front foot when you pivot in the kids' class, a bunny dies. Right? It's really important from here, when you move your front foot, it doesn't move. Alright? Everybody stand up. And what I like, just everybody put your, we'll start to put your left foot forward. Alright? So, basically on the count of one, Kamae is 60-40. Then on the count of two, you pivot wide and low down to 80-20. Then on the count of two, you cross step back and you pull your front foot back when you're cross stepping back. So your weight stays forward even though you're moving backwards. Alright? It's called Hyako Hachi Judo Kaiten. Ready? Itch. Hey. Again, make sure when you cross it back, you must pull your front foot back. I will show you why later. Itch. Oh, I see some people looking down. Hey. Itch. Nay. Itch. That's good, Chris. Very nice. Nay. Again, make sure the feeling when you do the pivot, it has to be with power. So as you turn, send your energy forward and keep it forward as you cross step back. Itch. Nay. Itch. Nay. Itch. Nay. Itch. Nay. Itch. Training isn't fighting. fighting is easy. They attack, break their neck. You don't do Ikkyo or Nikkyo or Sankyo. You guys say Ikkyo, Nikkyo, or Sankyo, right? We say Ikkyo, Nikkyo, Sankyo because we do it better.
Let's say that again.
Let's go. Is that on camera too? That's kidding. Does anyone know why in Yoshikan we say Ikkyo, Nikkyo, you say Ikkyo, Nikkyo? Gozo Shiura Kancho Sensei said, because of the great respect he had for the blessing to start his own style, he kept the same terms that we learned from him. That's why we do it differently. Alright? And again, they're not going to, those, I don't know how it sounds, but almost I think those Ikkyo, Nikkyo, Sankyo, they're not Aikido. They're tools we use to teach what is Aikido, that connection to the opponent. Right? So whether it's harmonized movement or it's harmonized when they kill them, it's still harmonized. Right? So for our training, we keep our hips squareable so we learn our strong balance point, and it makes it easier then to study some principles in Yoshinkanai. You know, one of the most important principles is called Jushin Mai. Jushin Mai means weight forward. If your weight's in the center, you can't move. You can move, of course, with a sword or a punch. That's why when the karate people punch there, the weight's in the center because they don't have to throw. Or sword people, the weight's in the center because the sword does all the work. We have to figure out how to throw. So for example, that's a very good game. Turn up. So from here, Chris is going to throw Matt now. He's going to shuffle forward. Go ahead. Alright? So you don't need power. What you need is concentration. 100% focus. And that's what these movements and all these techniques teach us. So once more, try again, please. From here. And he's still going to be pushing, so don't worry about him. Just a nice, easy turn. There you go. Just try the nice, easy pivot. Does anyone want to feel it? So the strength comes, the block, the strength. That's all you have to do. How's that feel? You stand up. And the nice thing is, if it, you know, I'm not doing anything. That's what's really kind of cool. I feel really cool. All right? But the serious, if it sounds pompous, forgive me, but the reality is, if you can't do that nice basic pivot with strong form and focus, you won't be able to do this. I'll try that pivot. Go ahead. Hey, you don't have to sit, Cesar. But again, if you're going to be blocking, make sure your left foot's forward. The person striking strikes with their right hand with their right foot forward. You want to do the other side? You change it. Because in Yoshinkan Aikido, we make a clear thing for the basic technique and more advanced. Because you don't want beginners doing this. Standardized. This is called a knee technique. So I'm left, he's right, and then he strikes. Good. And then turn. Alright. So you can cross step and strike. You can cross step and block. There are no rules. But for beginners, those of you who teach, know it's pretty hard. Right? So we standardize. I'm on left, he's on right, block, turn. And again, don't forget the feeling. Please. This is the idea. When you strike, you have to have the intent. You don't have to hit hard, but you have to have the intent. And in my dojo, if Shite doesn't block, you hit them. When they get tired of blocking with their forehead, they'll put their arm up. But you have to have the intent, even slowly. There. This is your target. And if he really wants to hit me, he will go back. If you think about it, right? You kiss my girlfriend. Nobody does that. Understand what I mean? Once at the seminar, it was really funny because usually I do it with guys and I wasn't even thinking. And I had a woman, I don't remember who, and I said, and I saw the girl, I said, you kissed my boyfriend. And then I realized what I said and everybody broke out laughing. And apparently my face was really red. If you think about it, if you want to hit someone, here, sure. Then it's coming there. When you do the shoryuchi, you have to hit. And then, again, you learn the idea to relax when you strike. And then it's still really young, yet you still call for it. Go ahead. You hear it, it's like a different sound. You have to relax when you hit. No power. It's good to start. It's no good. Go ahead, tap. Crispy. You have to make sure when the strike comes, you can't grab it. You can't block this way. It will go right through. The mind will protect you, so when you come on a strike, it will go that way. And that's what we want. He might move you, or he'll go that way. Alright? And again, remember, when he strikes, that's the idea we want. So after you block, make sure you pivot. Usually this doesn't person who attacks is called uke. And they each have separate moves. So from the striking pivot, I'd like you to go to practice what's called shomen uchi, ikajo sai ni. Alright? And it's standard. Does anyone here have a baseball bat? Right here? Alright. If your uke is fighting and resisting you, get a baseball bat, whack him a couple of times in the back, and that usually softens him up. Alright? Uke's job is to help Shitei understand the technique. So you don't resist until I say. Alright? And again, it's going to be different for you guys because you might do it a different way. But I'm wearing the dress, usually. But I'm not wearing the dress today. Alright? So what we want, we'll see. And again, in Yoshinkan, it's very stylized. Now, if you want later, I'll explain how the teaching system started. But again, from here, it's, I'm on left, Zed's on right, you move in, he strikes, block. He's still pushing, so I want to practice this pivot and shift. That's all this movement is for. Pivot around, down, and he comes right around for me. You finish here. Alright? The idea for combat is now the technique's over. Alright? But we drop the hand to the knee, so we can again practice dropping our hip down and relaxing. If you get this right idea, it's difficult for Ned to get up because he has to lift my whole 10 stone with his elbow. Right? And then if you get clunky and you want to mess that up, you do it like I did this afternoon. You get out, come out.
Basic movements, we practice three principles. One, moving forward,
2, hymeny, and 3, it's called jushin ido, shifting. If you get it quite right, and you have a very good uke, it feels really nice, doesn't it? And it's kind of like right to the ground. But it's a way we can learn to practice the shift and the movement. You can always make a big movement smaller. You understand what I mean? Right? But it's really hard to make a small movement bigger. And again, like I said, these movements are designed to teach us how to get rid of tension. And then in one day, maybe, you start to understand that the real power from Aikido comes from the mind and body working together. If you use your arms, that is good when you're young and strong. Right? Because there's very few people that get quite old and they still have a lot of arm strength. You should see me do push-ups. And I know I look very young, but actually I'm pretty old. Right? I'm 55. The guys I see that are really strong in Aikido when they're 75, the power has to come from your body. Right? And if it's difficult to do the pivot, that's just the way it is. You have to keep practicing. Right? Which, again, is why uke helps with the technique, so you don't feel you're dragging a big sack of potatoes around. You understand what I mean? So, from here, again, he strikes. Alright? So the idea from here is, again, it's opposite, doesn't matter. He can cross-step strike, I cross-step block. But again, for beginners, it's difficult. So we set it up here, so he strikes, I block. He's still pushing, so as I move, he's going to come around. And it's right here. Then, I make a connection. Left hand, left knee, left hip, center line, everything goes together. Just and then the knee's in the armpit. And then it's just here. So everything moves together. He has to lift my whole body weight with his elbow. And I'm not using anything. How's that feel? Good, that's what we want. Right? And like I said, then you can do what I did till now. And you don't have to be immovable, but I'm not doing anything. How's it feel? Alright? That's what these techniques are designed for. Alright? Because realistically, for fighting, I won't do it, but if you have bad strikes, you just break the neck, slam his head down into the ground. But who wants to train with someone who's trying to break your neck? Raise your hand. Nobody. Oh, you're not sure.
No.
That's not it. The potential for danger, the potential for abuse in Aikido is great. Because he's not supposed to resist me. Right? So you can start thinking you're really strong. Those of you who know me well, I am a boxing fanatic. I don't do it anymore because I'm old. Getting hit in the head is not too good for you. If you hit someone and they fall down, you say sorry, 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 but it's like that. But when they hit you and you fall down, that really sucks. Alright? And I've been in both camps. So the idea here, he's helping me, so we don't try to kill each other. Except if I don't throw men hard, he'll go home and sulk. So I have to hit him hard. So once you understand that, it doesn't matter. From that shomurichi block, it falls! It's your elbows.
Oops.
But again, for boxing, I can hit you, you can't hit me.
Oops.
You have to go like that. Who's going to win? Alright? So I think it's really important when we train this way, then you can understand the power. And then, just as you touch, you can do shomurichi kagyo saini without moving. Alright? It's very cool. Just from here. And it's very powerful. Close your eyes, Lucy, please. Just from there. Very small movement equals a big reaction. You understand what I mean?
Us.
Even from here. Ikkyo. How's it feel?
Let's follow!
Throw a piece around the face. Because it doesn't hurt.
It hurt. It doesn't take.
Now here, it looks like it hurts.
Follow!
Throw a piece around the face. It doesn't hurt. Alright? harder because they learn the proper luke to protect themselves. And then one day, you put them right between the cracks of the mat, and they get up and they say, that was great. If you do that, your IQ goes to a whole new level. And you can't do that if you're hurting people and smashing and using muscle. That's what these techniques teach us. Okay? Let's take a little quick water break and then we'll continue. Chris has asked me for the guy sheet. And what I like, instead of doing the technique, what I like you to think about is he understands a lot more now.
Who be the name?
Lip Sensei.
I hope he really understands now. What I'd like you to think about, Kote Gaishi, when you write the Japanese characters, Kote Gaishi. Ko means small, Kei means hand, Gaishi means to turn. And again, it's nothing to do with pain compliance. If you twist and get kind of straight here, move it up to here, like I see some forms of Mikey don't do, it's okay as long as you get just along for the ride. But if I'm this way, you really should hit me in the head. What we want to do is keep the hand relaxed. Now it's interesting to move your arm around. By grabbing hard, it starts moving me around. So you grab it soft. Now he doesn't know when the correction is coming. And then you can turn it over. So I'd like your first to try that nice and easy. And even one hand, it's very interesting. Alright? I think it's time to tell them the Zoltan story.
What's first?
Right, I got lots of stories, but this is called the Zoltan story, so cross your legs if you like. Alright, I have one student, his name is Zoltan. If you can imagine, it's just like it sounds.
I'm Zoltan, I do work with I'm Zoltan.
My daughter was training, she trained from the time she was 5 until she was 11. And now she does dance. So don't let her do dance, right? Because they only defect. But she's a wonderful, fabulous dancer. She does jazz, ballet, tap, and hip-hop. She is naturally talented in dance. But some of her friends graduated from the adult class to the kids class. I mean, from the kids class to the adult class. And she wanted to try training with her friends. She was 10. And I thought, okay. So we did the same technique that we were just doing, Shomenuchi Ikajo Osai Ni, and my daughter, who's 10, who's half Japanese, and oh my God, is she gorgeous. That's Rick. She's gorgeous. Her partner was Zoltan. And she knew, even though she was 10, she knew she sensed his daughter. So I was so proud of her, I almost cried, because she was facing this.
I'm Zoltan.
She's facing Zoltan, and she's like this. Because she knows she sensed his daughter. My heart was pounding, I was so proud of her, I almost cried. The best part was Zoltan.
I am Zoltan, martial arts, muscular.
You can see it. Oh my God, I got sensed his daughter. If I hurt her, he's going to kill me. Oh my God, I don't know what to do. So he did the technique, and he just went. I killed him anyways. But it's very interesting. So I'd like you to do the Kote Gaishi now and pretend
you're Zoltan.
Emily. But I call her Poopy, but better edit that from the camera.
Yes.
It's going to be bad when she's 18 and I meet her first boyfriend. How long you know Poopy? Yeah. It's nice and easy. And if you resist,
hey! Use less power.
Works better.
Oh.
But don't resist for now. Nice and easy. Hey! Trying to get that feeling. Go ahead and get
started. Yes!
So if you just want to see again the basic techniques, you can do it from any stripe. But I don't want to take too much to be effective. For example, if you're having mochi, the thing that you need is this way. One, two, shift, three, four, and then look around, take your rest, and then let's go. How Lucy doesn't hurt.
It doesn't hurt, darling.
Doesn't hurt, darling. Talk to me or talk to Lucy. Right? Listen, again, the idea here is just control the elbow there, using your body power. Straight face and smiling, and that's what we want. And again, from this basic technique, the idea is moving forward, break his balance, then I can shift, turn, get the weight forward, pull over, and over down. Yeah. Okay. So we make sure, lock the shoulder, and the elbow, and then come shoulder down there. Alright? So that's the idea of the basic technique. We're going to try now a little bit of a variation. So I need you to try. Same idea of Koki Gaishi, but just Koki. Okay, just try that. Don't get tense. It's like you have it here, lift there, and relax. Questions? Okay, we've got Nick and Neil here now. Feeling? Yeah. Right? And again, these basic techniques designed to teach us how to use our whole body and arms together. Alright, let's go right to the technique. Straight to right. From here, high strike. Hey! Deep block, across the back. Whoop! Nothing to miss this one. So again, the idea when you strike, hey! Don't step straight back. A little bit of an angle so he's off balance. And then over and down. Finish back straight. Hands out in front of you. Let's go down. Yes!
Yes!
Good sensei. I think it might be better, if you don't mind. And who wants to see me nail sensei Phil with this technique? Again, I stress, he's very strong, so if I step straight back, he won't move. So you have angle. Let's work this. Look easy. Didn't look easy. Okay. It's really hard, but it's fun. It's really hard. Again, you have to breathe. All right? But that's the idea. Moving your heart. Arm and legs together. Go ahead and try. Good luck.